Today, we will be feeding the Cory catfish and, well, everything in my 29-gallon tank. We'll be feeding them live black worms. Here we go. The fish absolutely love these things. Especially the Cory catfish. Not only do they love the live black worms, but this is also pretty much the main ingredient or food that I use to get the Cory catfish to breed. I'm working on making a video for that right now. These fish are beautiful. They're nice and big. They literally won't. Whenever I put this in the tank, they go crazy. But it's super cool watching them eat. They just suck it up like you're eating a noodle. And all the other fish like it too. The other fish that I have in here with them are all peaceful fish. I have my blue-green Moscow guppies. I have some Corydoras cestatus. That's the little Cory you see right in the middle, just sitting there, in the not on the bottom, but just sitting there in the air, or elevated. They're not strict bottom fish like the Sterbai Cory cats. And then I have some celestial pearl danios, some ember tetras, and some pseudomugal luminatus rainbow fish. But I've been having a lot of fun with these Sterbai Cory cats lately. They've been spawning a ton for me, and I'm working on a video right now. I'll show you, give you a little preview at the end of this, but the Corys are just getting into the pile of black worms. And usually, the same day or the day after I feed these, they start laying eggs. So if you want to get your Cory catfish to spawn, highly would recommend using live black worms. And if you just want to see like some cool behavior out of your quarries, a lot of black worms will do the trick and make them super excited. I'll give you a little preview. I just had a little koi fry hatch, and I'm working on making a video of raising these fry. Well, hope you like seeing the koris eat, and if you want to see more videos like this, and you want to see videos on how to spawn the Cory catfish and raise the eggs, please like and subscribe, and hope you have a good day.